Hey everyone, today I'm going to show you how to merge shapes inside of Articulate Storyline. It is a relatively new feature, allows you to take two different objects, and it's been something I've been wanting since day one inside of Storyline. Allows you to take two different objects and merge them together into one shape. Now you still can't go as deep as you can with like Illustrator, where you can then manipulate little points on the shape, but it's a good step forward and it allows you to take different shapes, put them as one object, and then not have to group them or anything like that. So you could still create some pretty custom shapes here. So let's go ahead and dive right into Storyline. And I have just my download file. You can download this and check it out if you go to learningdojo.ninja. And I'll keep a link at the very bottom of the video. And you can say learningdojo.ninja/JavaScript snippets. Even though we're not working with JavaScript, you can still, if you need something to download, you can download the project file. Now I'm just going to create an actual blank file here. And inside of that blank file, let's go ahead and play around with this merge shapes capability. So if I come into insert, let's go ahead and add a shape here. And we'll add one shape, which is going to be a rectangle shape here. And then we are going to add another shape. Let's go ahead and have this shape be a triangle or something like that. So we'll have a triangle right there. Now, one thing that you'll notice, especially with like rectangles, this is also relatively new. If you take this shape, you can actually adjust the curves just by dragging any one of those dots next to the corner of your shape. If you hold down the Option or Alt button, it will actually just manipulate one side as well. So if you wanted all four corners to manipulate, just don't hold anything down, but if you just wanted one, either do Option if you're on a Mac using Parallels, or if you're on PC, then you use Alt as far as that goes. That allows you to get more just out of the box custom shapes than what we could before. So that's really exciting here. Let me go ahead and just adjust that back, and I'm gonna change this back to kind of like a skinny rectangle here. Now what I'm gonna do is I'm going to merge these two shapes together. I want to rotate this to 90 degrees, and then I'm gonna go ahead and just take those two shapes, and let's say that I wanted to create like this custom arrow. Now you can add an arrow, I'm just trying to show you the different things that you can do. But if you wanted to, you can come in and just hold down the Shift button, and then all you have to do is right click and then go down to Merge Shapes. Now this is pretty standard across any kind of tool like visual tool, Photoshop, Illustrator, anything like that, they have these options where you can combine the two. You can actually exclude the two where it will just cut, it's still separate, but it cuts anything that's kind of overlapped, will cut that out. You can actually fragment where each little part becomes its own individual shape. And notice what happens to the timeline down at the bottom here is it adds three different shapes there. Now you can also intersect where everything becomes one shape. Everything that's not intersecting goes away, but everything that is intersecting will stay there. And you can see it's a tiny little part there. Or you can subtract whatever was on top would actually subtract from the shape, which is very helpful in certain situations as well. But let's go ahead and just do a union. And then now I have this one shape. So one shape that I can move, one shape that I could add triggers to, everything like that. So it becomes really useful to just be able to add that one or to combine them together. And now I don't have to group them where you might accidentally select just one part of the group. You just have one shape there going forward. Now, it would be nice if I could then just manipulate like little points here and get into something similar that I can do inside of Illustrator. I don't see them doing that specific thing, but it is at least helpful for this part here. Now, the other thing that I like to do is I like to use shapes to kind of add some additional style. So I'm gonna come in here and add just kind of a circle shape here. And I'm gonna have this be off the stage a little bit because I want this shape to just add this little curve, but I want it to not show the edges. And it's not going to do that. Like previously, this is what would happen is I could get this nice little curve. Let me make sure it's not on the stage. And you can see here that it will only show what's visible on the stage there. That's great, but sometimes it drives me nuts when I can't see this end of the stage, because if I'm aligning things, I don't know exactly where things end here. So one useful thing, and this may just be me, this just may be how I function, But what I could do is I could cut the parts that I don't want out. So I'm going to zoom out here. Instead of fit to window, I'm actually going to zoom out a little bit, and so I can see my entire stage. Now what I can do is I can insert my, or like a rectangle, and I can just have that go right to the top of my stage here and make sure that it overlaps on my object. And if I hold shift down to that and I right click and go to merge shapes and merge shapes, I can subtract it, and that way it cuts it out. So this is a way that even though I can't manipulate the different points, this is a way that I can cut out different parts as well. Again, you may not want to spend the time doing that, but this is something that I am excited about because it drives me nuts to have that overlap. So let's go ahead and just stretch that out, and it will give me the kind of the placement of where that the end of that shape is or the end of the stage is. And so I'm going to go ahead and merge shapes and then subtract from there. And I did a little too far, but that's okay. You can go back, and I think this is the edge of the stage right there. Oh, actually, right there is the edge. So now let's go ahead and subtract that, and there we go. Now, if I wanted to, actually, probably one more thing is I'd want to stretch this out so I don't have that extra remaining part. So let's right-click and go to Merge Shapes, Subtract, and there we go. So I'd want to do that for the final one, too. But it's just a way for us to be able to create custom shapes. Just a small feature, but it's tremendously helpful, and I'm glad that it was actually implemented here. One other thing, because I called it out before, is if you are working with a rectangle, for example, let's come in here and add this rectangle. If you didn't want to visually drag out the corners, now if you go under Format, there is the ability to add overall. You can add like, okay, rounded corners. Let's do 5, for example. And then it will add a 5 to all rounded corners. If you wanted to do based on percentages, you can do that. If you wanted to do just based on a corner where this one is 40, that one is 10, and so forth, you can do that through that little drop-down box as well. So I wanted to point that out there. Just make sure that you were aware of that. Now, if you like this video, head on over to my YouTube channel, click the like button, as well as subscribe to my channel, and hit the bell notification so you get notified of all future videos as they come out. That really helps my channel, allows me to continue to grow, allows me to produce these videos for you to really help you become the best learning developer that you can be. Also, if you wanted to check out full courses, you can head on over to my website at learningdojo.ninja. I have courses in Articulate Storyline 360, JavaScript for Storyline, XAPI Fundamentals, Articulate Rise, and Custom SCORM. You can also check out all of my free blog posts. I have everything posted there. You can search for anything related to AI, Camtasia, XAPI, JavaScript, and you can come up to the top and search for something specific as well. I have over 200 videos that I've produced in the past couple of years. So that's all I have for today. So thanks, everyone, and I'll see you next time.